Hi, this is Melanie Fine of Chem in 10. Today's question is, in Rutherford's experiment, a thin gold foil was bombarded with alpha particles. According to Thomson's plum pudding model of the atom, what should have happened? A, every alpha particle should have gone through the foil. B, every alpha particle should have been deflected by the foil. C, every alpha particle should have bounced directly back. Or D, every alpha particle should have gotten stuck in the foil. Rutherford is honored as the scientist who discovered the nucleus, but that wasn't what he set out to do. It was a new time, it was the turn of the century in the 1900s, and radioactivity had just been discovered by Becquerel and the Curies, and Rutherford was really into the radioactivity as well. And he wanted to figure out what the effect radioactivity had on other things, like other forms of matter. One of the first things he had to do was he had to count the number of alpha particles that were being given off by his uranium sample. And the way he counted is they'd actually hit a screen that was made of zinc sulfide, and every time an alpha particle would hit the screen, there'd be a flash of light, a green flash of light, and he'd count them. Well, actually, probably his assistant, Hans Geiger, of the Geiger counter, would count them. But they came so fast, and they were so jumbled up together that he needed a way to spread them out more so that he could count them better. And so they used gold foil to help deflect it. And what they found was something just bizarre. They thought the gold foil, I don't know if it would deflect it, but slow it down a little bit, or at least just spread out the particles so that they could count them easier. Because of this plum pudding model, the positive charge, which alpha particles were also positively charged, was so evenly spread out that there wasn't enough positive charge to repel the positive charge of the alpha particles. Remember that like charges repel. So he expected the alpha particles to go through the foil, but perhaps be deflected a little bit. What he got was that some of these alpha particles did go through and hit the zinc sulfide screen. Some were deflected, some were deflected more than others. And on occasion, he would actually get an alpha particle that shot right back at the source. He's noted for saying that it was like shooting bullets at a piece of tissue paper, and the bullet would shoot right back at you. It was that astonishing something to happen for the alpha particle to be completely deflected back to its source. So he theorized that the positive charge was not throughout the atom like the plum pudding model, but that it was concentrated in a dense positive center. And when the alpha particle hit this dense positive center of one of the gold foil atoms, it would be deflected. And if it hit it dead on, of course, it would bounce right back at the source. So Rutherford theorized that the atom is mostly empty space, but there's a small dense positive center called the nucleus. The electrons, he theorized, were scattered outside the nucleus. Rutherford had already won a Nobel Prize for his work in radioactivity, and he actually won a second Nobel Prize for his discovery of the nucleus. So the correct answer is that what should have happened is that every alpha particle should have gone through the foil. If you like this video, be sure to join us at chemin10.com, where we deliver the chemistry question of the day daily to your inbox. There are more chemistry videos and practice problems. You get help from our online chemistry community, and membership is always free. This is Melanie Fine with Chem in 10.